Good morning, and welcome to Cheney Orchards in Brimfield. We have been in business since 1911, where my grandfather started the company, things have changed a lot since then. We've downsized tremendously, and now we raise some apples for food bank purposes. We want to show you some things about pruning. Across the street here, you'll see an espalier. That's what you call this shaping of trees, whether it's apple trees or something else. In our case, of course, it happens to be apple trees. And we planted the individual small trees. And I mean, something that is half an inch in diameter, basically, when you start. And the important thing was to get the spacing right, which we kind of fooled with a little bit in just trying to figure out how they would grow. And then make a re-rod, a cement, quarter inch cement re-rod shape of the word Cheney, and put that in the ground next to the tree. And as the tree starts to grow and put the limbs out, you just cut the ones off that you don't want and shape the others by tying them to the re-rod with, you know, you can even do it with a string or anything like that that will hold the tree to the re-rod. And then as time goes on, we could actually take that re-rod is still there. You can't see it, but the re-rod could be taken away and the tree would hold that shape. So it's kind of a neat thing. You could do something like that against the side of a building, so it has, you know, four limbs going out either side or something like that. The other thing I wanted to show you, have a little bit of tar to me this way. Excuse the noise. One more, please. This is a flowering crab apple that's pretty old. I think it's around 40 years old, but I wanted to show you. I wanted to show you what can be done with a big old tree like this. Now, I did take some top work out of that, as you can see, but it's got a beautiful shape, something nice to have in your yard. And if it was a producing tree of apples you would eat, I mean, these you can make jelly out of, you won't need them. But this is what you can do in your own yard and have a nice structured tree. Well, it's still the same day, but we've moved locations, as you see now. And this is a dwarf tree, as opposed to some that we have that are bigger. And nowadays, most of the orchards are dwarf trees of some type, and some are planted very close together, and others are further apart, and depending on what the grower is trying to accomplish. Now, initially, the tree does not hold itself up when they're dwarfs, and so they have to be anchored. And that's what you see the pole in the center of the tree is anchoring this tree. You don't need it now, because that tree is probably 25 years old. It doesn't look it, but I think it is around that age. So the pole, you just didn't take time to take the pole out. It wasn't necessary, so it's still there. So we've got a tree that's not too bad here. It's a little thick. It hasn't been pruned in a couple of years. So I'm going to just take some thinning cuts out of it and so on. My tools today, I have a pair of loppers. If we want to use that, you can use that. It's a good pruning tool. And here's a couple of other things. This is one of my favorites, because you can reach up and just snip off a branch like that. It's very easy, it's light, it's easy to handle. You can work the top of the tree with it. I'll show you about doing that a little bit later. The other thing you can do that I'm not too excited about, but it will reach all the way up, and you can actually saw a limb off the tree with a motion like this, you see, and it would just cut this limb off, and that limb would fall out of there. You can hook it out of there with the pole. So that's another pruning method. And the third thing I'll show you is, well, let me just mention my pruning saw. This is the thing you use the most. It's a very simple pruning saw, lightweight and easy to maneuver around the tree, and cuts easily, so that if we're wanting to get in here and cut off some of these, this is what I call sucker growth. It does fine. You can do it that way, and that's very easy as well. So we pruning saw, simple hand tool. The thing I use the most nowadays is an electric shear. It will cut a pretty good piece of material, as you can see, and very easy to use. And it's fast. And so as you go around the tree, you'll see how easy this comes off. What I'm after in a tree is something with kind of a Christmas tree shape. As you see, we're headed that way somewhat. I like to see the bottom turned upward, the top kind of leveled off, and the general slope of the tree inward. You think Christmas tree in your mind, Christmas tree shape. That way you get light penetration, to the maximum light penetration, so the apples get color. The thing, if your tree is too thick, which some of this is, you just don't get color in the tree. Now, I will probably, you'll think I'm gonna kill the tree practically the way I prune, but opening up the light, opening up, getting the light in, giving the tree vigor is what gives you the best quality apples. So I'll get started here and try to make a few comments. I want the limbs to go away from the tree. I want them to kind of head upward. This tree isn't too bad in that respect. And maybe we'll level off a little bit here or there, as I did with that first cut with the pole, and cut some other pieces out and give you an idea what to look for. So let me get started here. We'll just take off some of this inner stuff on the tree. So you don't want a limb going back into the tree, and not a lot of limbs. We can, like this, and pull them back in some, and that kind of thing. So in here, now we've got one limb over the other. We got a higher limb here. This would tend, with fruit weight, maybe would tend, it would drop down a lot. And so we make a little room for that as well. And what do we got? We got a few low limbs here and here and here. We just go along and cut these off. Let's go back a little further here, get that all opened up a little bit. And then you got some of this stuff in close, like it has spurs on it and that kind of thing. You're never going to get any good apples off the interior like this. You want the tree to be open, because those apples are still, no matter what you do, are going to be shaded. Okay, we'll kind of move around here. I'm not a big fan of this limb here. It's going down a lot. It's inside the tree. Let me move around so I give you a little bit better view. So we've got a few twigs in here. I call these suckers, they're water sprouts. These that virtually have no limbs on them. And they don't give you any apples until the second year of growth. The first year they'll they'll produce the buds for the following year. So I'm kind of going along here, as you can see, thinning this thing out, opening it up, giving it direction. Some of this downgoing stuff can be taken off and that kind of thing. This one here is going back. We'll take that out. You see, we're getting things kind of opened up. Maybe you're saying, wow, I don't know if I'd like to do that to my home tree. It looks like it's going to kill it. But that won't happen. Okay, now I'm hitting this kind of hard. I know, but that's what gives you the good apples. Now this over here, I don't think you can see this. But what it's doing is we've got a one limb above the other, a complex here. I'll pull that. We got two or three here I want to cut, but one limb above the other, and I want to take this low limb off, you see. And I also want to come this one in back in here. This limb right back in here has really no place to grow, and so I'm going to take that off as well. Okay, now a little bit in the top, what I'll try to do here is level the top off a little bit. Let's see, this one right here, I'm going to get right up in the tree and do this so you can see what I'm doing. We'll take this down goer off. Okay, and we've got one going up quite a bit here. So I think you can kind of get an idea of what we're after from doing this type of thing. Probably the thing I would have done instead of climbing up there was use the pole that I told you about earlier. But I don't really like that one. So take that one off too. So you can see I'm taking off quite a bit of material, but we're getting a tree that's quite open. That'll give us some good color. Now the other thing you want to look for is any sucker growth or anything like that at the base of the tree. This one fortunately doesn't have any, so that's not a problem. So that gives you an idea, hopefully, of what you want to shoot for. This tree's fairly opened up and should give us a nice crop of apples. You can keep pruning here and there, but it's not necessary. All right, so that's an idea on a dwarf tree. Now there's a tree around behind you there.
Are you shut off now?
Okay, there's a tree around you, right behind you there, that is, this was a Macintosh, and that's a Cortland. That tree I had pruned about a month and a half ago, and you can see there I'd cut some bigger limbs off, and that's kind of got not quite so much of a Christmas tree shape, but it's open and will give you some good apples. Now, we've moved up the hill a little bit from where we were, and this is the oldest tree on the farm. It's a Roxbury russet, which is a well-known old variety. It makes wonderful cider. It makes a cider that's syrupy and gives the cider good consistency. But the interesting thing about it, I hope you can shoot down here to see this. This is part of the stump from my grandfather's tree. The tree itself rotted, and this is the sucker, came up from the stump, and then as it grew, I shaped it into the tree that it is. And we're hoping, I've donated this to Old Sturbridge Village for its farm that they're going to set up an orchard and so on down there, and we're hoping to have this tree grow there. Now one other thing I want to point out, that you see this old stump is still shooting out suckers. And you want to cut those out because they're a nuisance in the around the base of the tree. You want to keep the tree kind of the area around the base of the tree kind of open and cleaned out, because the number one predator in orchards is mice. And mice get in under the tree like this and eat the bark off the roots and kill the tree. And it's hard to believe that little creature is the number one pest in the orchard that you have to control. So I'm going to take these suckers off, just like you saw me do with the other. And while I'm doing that, you just cut these down, get rid of them, get this cleaned out down near the base. Okay? Now, so that we take care of cleaning that up, and then we'll go along and we'll prune a few limbs off of this. I have one other tool that I didn't mention that we can use. This is a pruning ladder. The three-legged idea is that you can put it on any ground and have it stand for you. If you had four legs on it, you'd find you'd have trouble getting balance. But the one thing you want to remember about a ladder like that, the leg always goes up the hill. Because if you don't do that, you'll take a nice ride in the wrong direction. Okay, so let me just touch this tree up a little bit while I'm here. I'll move around, hopefully, where you can see me. We're back and thinking about suckers. Now, we're not going to do this tree quite as hard as we did the other tree, because this is going to be used for cider apple purposes, I'm sure. So what we'll want to do basically is think about having the limbs kind of open, go away from the tree, don't cross back in too much into the tree, that type of thing. As you'll notice in the top there, we're pretty thick and so on, so I'm going to clean that out. I'll give some of the limbs some new direction, and we'll kind of call it quits. We got, see like what I'm talking about? See this right here? This is not very good because we've got a couple of limbs right together there. Usually you kind of take the bottom one off. Now we get the tree, we just lift this up a little like that and get the bottom limbs out of your way. Then let's clean the inside up some. Some of these small ones here and there, get that opened up, and then you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to also